Everybody, I told you in the first day, Java is object-oriented programming language. We will create objects, but to create object, we need class. By using class, we can create object. Over here, I am using scanner class. I am creating scan object. This is scan, its name is scan object. But to create an object from a class, you need to use new keyword. If you don't type new over here, Java cannot understand it should create an object. If I want you to bring me tea, I should tell you tea. If I don't tell you tea, you cannot understand to bring me tea. It is impossible. Same thing, everybody. If you don't tell new to Java, Java cannot create object. New means for Java, create object. Is this clear, everybody? Every time, if you wanna create an object, you have to tell new. New is a command for Java to create object. Okay. And then I am telling to Java, pay attention. Can you see over here? I am telling to Java, hey Java, there are many colors, I confused. Okay, over here, I told Java, hey Java, you will create an object from scanner class. Can you see I am telling object from scanner. The class which the object will be created from. Okay. If you don't type over here scanner class name, Java cannot understand which class will be used to create object. By typing new, I told Java create object. By typing class name, I told Java, use that class to create object. So Java will create object from scanner class. I am telling you, T from China. Okay. New object from scanner class. Okay, that one. And then focus over here. What is that? What is that? Pink one. System in. To print something on the console, what were we typing? System.out we were typing. System.out.println. For example, hi. To print something, I was telling system out. Over here, I am telling system in. Everybody, system means the code which you are typing. Okay? System means the code which you are typing. This is user. User will give you three, for example, as data. What will you do? You will come, get three, put it into the code. Because of that, you are telling in. You are telling to Java, hey Java, you will get the data from outside. User is outside. You will get the data from outside and put it in. Because of that, we are telling in over here. But over here, we were telling out. Why? Because inside the code, I have a data. I am telling to Java, hey Java, put the data out. Because console is outside the code. Console is that one. Your codes are over here. Console is over here. Console is outside your codes. Because of that, when you print something on the console, you are telling system out. But user is outside. If you wanna get data from him, you have to tell system.in. Is it clear or I confused? Actually, that part is not so important, everybody, but I want you to know something about the code which you are typing. Of course, console is output, is for output, Kerem. Let me share that one. Okay. Pay attention. This is the class name. We imported that class to be able to use in our code. This is the first step. Second one, this is the object name. Every time when we create a data, we name it. Can you see? I created class, I named it. I am creating an object, I should name it. Okay, new means, everybody, new means create object for Java. After new, if you type the class name, it means create object by using that class. Okay. Why did I use in over here? Why did I use in over here? Because user is outside, but the data which user will give will come into my code. Because of that, I am telling in to Java. Get the data in. Because of that, we are typing in over here. Okay, first step is done, everybody. Second step is easier because the first step is essential. Everybody, if you want user to give you a data, you have to talk with user. You have to tell him, give me your age, give me your name, give me your country. If you don't tell something to user, user cannot know what to give. In the second step, you will send a message to user. Again, I don't have a main method. Let us create main method, everybody, and then put the codes in it. Public static void main, create main method, please. Then put those into it. Let me share the code. You can copy and paste. First step, I explained. In the second step, we will give a message to user, system out println. For example, enter your age. Okay. Enter your age. User will see that message and user will understand he should enter his age. In the third step, everybody, in the third step, I will get the age from user and put it into memory. Pay attention. Inside the memory, I will create a reserved area. Why am I using int? I asked age. Age will be int every time. For age, using byte is better. Yes, when you do a real application, use byte. But over here, I don't want to confuse you. For whole numbers, I will use int every time. Because when we learn, we don't have any problem about memory. It will be enough. Okay. I made the data type int because I am asking age. Age will be int. It is okay. Now, why are you typing over here age? This is the name of the variable. If you want, make it my age, your age, whatever you want, you can do. I am making just age over here. And then I will tell to Java, hey, Java, by using scan object, use put dot, everybody. After typing scan over here, put dot. Can you see there are many methods over here? There are many methods. Use next int. Why are you using next int? Because user will give me integer. That one will take the integer from user and put it into age. What happened over here? Pay attention. This is user, everybody. When I execute the code, user will see that message on the console. After getting that message, user will give me his age, 12, for example. Okay. And then next int that method. That method will go and get the 12 from the user and then put it into memory. This is reserved area in memory. 12 will be put into age reserved area. After executing that code in my memory, I will have 12 in it. If I print the age on the console, let us print it on the console. Age, I will put a label over here as well. The user's age is that one. The user's age will be 12 if user gives 12. If user gives 100, I will see the user's age is 100 on the console. Let us execute the code. Can you see it says enter your age? It is waiting for me to enter my age. I am entering 12. Can you see I entered 12? After entering 12, press enter. Can you see it says the user's age is 12. I gave user into the system. System put it into age container in memory. When I tell print it, it is printing. Okay, let us execute one more time. It is waiting for me to enter age. Put the pointer over here, type 100. Press enter. Can you see it says the user's age is 100. Whatever user gives, it will be put into age container. Is it clear? We will do many examples about, no worries. You should understand 60% and then 70%. Bilal, I put 100. Can you see? It tells me, enter your age. Put your pointer over here on the console. And then type 23, for example. 23 is coming from me. I am user over here. After typing 23, press enter. Can you see it says user's age is 23? Okay. The functionality of next int is for getting data from user. Over here, user is putting 23. Next int is getting 23 and putting it into the memory. And then from the memory, I am using the data. Okay. Let us do one more. Everybody. Okay. Let us create one more class and do all the steps from the beginning to make it more sure. Okay. Save that class. Go to file and save all. If you want to save your code on IntelliJ, go to File and then Save All. If you click on Save All, it will save everything which you did today.